Hello everyone, formerly known as Trevor Master here, but you guys can call me Charles Presti now. Welcome to the channel, as there is a name change now, but it's quite new because we're going to be doing a bit of K1 Speed is finally back open for the Challenge Grand Prix 4 in Orlando. Thank goodness, because I was actually kind of getting cooped up in my house and I was kind of getting a little bored here, and I'm glad we're back up and running here. And right now we're going to be going in. It's July now for the finale, so we've missed out on 2 months worth of racing. I had footage for last month, but unfortunately it was all in time-lapse mode and it was not really usable footage really for me in terms of getting it cut up and sent up to YouTube, unfortunately. So we've already had a month worth of racing. So instead of, basically I'll do a quick little recap of what happened there. I basically went from having a 9-point gap to ahead of everybody to ended up having 2 because I had a nightmarish race. Of course, the one race that I had unusable footage, I had a bad race, so go figure for me. I mean, I could have put a time lapse up for you guys, but I don't have the footage anymore because it was just not usable. I was trying to get the footage slowed down just so I can show it to you guys, but I unfortunately couldn't. Right now you are seeing the qualifying footage at the moment, and we're actually getting ready. Right now I am in cart number 9, which was actually a pretty good cart in terms of being able to get the most out of it, but as you can see right here in my first initial start of the quality, I was just caught in this lump of traffic with these two guys were paddling away trying to get Chaucy for position to try to get their quality laps in, but they were really just hindering each other because I kept catching up to them really quickly. So I was thinking, you know what, try to back off at first and let them have all ton of space, but it just, as you can see there, I just closed up like nearly 3-4 seconds there really quickly. And as you can see, the GoPro actually fell down a little bit. I had the screw on a little too loose for that part of the lap. I noticed that, so I caught it and put it back up, luckily. But when you missed out, you just missed out on me going for an overtake on those guys. I'm like, you know what, they're moving too slow. Let's get past them so I can get my laps in. And yeah, it turned out pretty good. The session felt pretty good. The carts felt good. I'm gonna go ahead and let the lap times show what you guys are saying, because I have the lap times up in the top right corner for you guys to see. And I'll show you the results at the end of it, and I'll talk about that. But yeah, it's very good. I have a playlist up for most of the Challenge Grand Prix season for this 2020 season, as it's been a bit of a chaotic one, as the whole world global situation kind of put a hamper on things here. But it doesn't mean that we can't go race, and we have our social distancing protocols in to make sure we can do all this, and it's quite good that we can get back to racing after being locked up in our houses for a few months or so. Great. Hope you guys do enjoy. I'll probably be right back. I'll probably be here near the end of the qualifying. I'll talk about results and everything. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. If you guys skip to where the start of the race is, I'll see you guys there and all that good stuff. And right, thank you guys so much. I'll see you guys in a bit. So with qualifying getting wrapped up and underway, we actually got a really good result with a 25.776 or 5.76 that put me up into P3 for the A final, which is quite good. Right now, I'm showing you guys a time lapse of what happened for the B final. It basically, I'm gonna be trying to do this every single time I go to K1 now for the finales. Like if we have a separate final, I'll tell you the top three of the B final. So the B final, you had Nick DiMario, who was actually only a few points behind me in the whole entire championship. He actually got pushed down to the B final. He had a rough outing in terms of the cards for qualifying, but he ended up winning the race. He got first there, and then Spencer Palmer ended up in second, followed by, I can't remember who it was, but he was able to be left anyways. But now, back into our race. Now we're getting ready for the A finals, and my main race, getting ready. Actually, when we get ahead and get ready to go green here, you'll see I got a really good start, but unfortunately the pole man really bogged down so much it kind of negated any sort of advantage I had to possibly go for a second place position there. But yeah, from here on out, it was actually a pretty good well race because these guys that were in front of me were actually newer guys to the league night, so I wasn't sure how aggressive they were going to be in comparison to the drivers that I'm normally used to behind me. So what I was going to do is I was going to play it easy, see where they were on the race graph, because I tend to be, if you're very nice and play it very clean, I'll play very clean with you. Like, I don't tend to bump people a whole lot when everyone's playing clean. If you're dirty to me, I'll play dirty back, obviously, but not too intensely, if you get what I mean. But yeah, as you can see, as I was racing them a little bit, the race graph was like, they weren't going for anything, like, you know, ambitious, which I was finding that quite surprising as throughout this race, and it was continuing like that, and I'm like, okay, so we'll just race like this normally, we'll have proper race craft, like just trying to find a way around. Yes, it's a bit nearly impossible to overtake trying to do it this way, but it's almost more enjoyable doing it this way because you can find a way to get past in this cleaner scenario. It is much more satisfying, but it's quite good. Right. As you can see, we were kind of pulling a gap. The top three of us were kind of getting away from the drivers behind. The driver behind is David DeBree. He was actually started out fifth, I believe, and then he actually got a good start to get up in the fourth. But eventually, he got caught up by Chris, who was right behind me in the standings, 2 points behind me, and then he ended up going in fourth while us three just kind of drove away in our own little pack. We didn't tend to fight each other too much, which was quite good, to be honest, because it seemed like when we settled into this queue, it seemed like the carts that were in the positions they are right now seemed to be the cart performances, because near the end of the race, when the cart started dying, the cart in the lead started to pull away from second, and I started to lose a bit of ground from third. And it kind of worked out really well, so no one really held each other up too much. I mean, I got held up a little bit near in the beginning because my cart was very feisty off the start, but like near to the second half of the race, it just started to die out. It didn't have enough power to put down the same power output near the end of the race, so it just, but it ended up being a little slower. But yeah, it was quite a good race overall. So the rest of the race is kind of just doing a bit of a train. It wasn't really any argy-bargy or anything. It was just a nice little clean train. I quite enjoyed it. It was quite fun. See here, I actually got a really good exit out of there, so I was like, maybe I could try some around the outside, and that was like my last chance to try anything, because at that point the car started slowing down. But it was a move that I could try, but it was nice. It was like very clean race car. There was no little argy-bargy. I quite enjoyed it. And this shows you that how really good race cars can be pulled off in these kind of cars on a tighter track. And even though there wasn't really any proper like overtakes that happened, it was definitely an excellent display of very awesome racecraft from the top three of us. And even though these two guys are in front of us are new, they actually been doing league nights up in Jacksonville, a little bit, an hour and a half to 2 hours away from Orlando, and it was quite nice. You could tell too that they've done more than just this isn't their first rodeo around here. But yeah, it was quite good to have some new faces coming into the fray, and it was quite nice. So anyways, that's a bit enough of rambling for me. I hope you guys did enjoy this. You guys can go ahead and watch the rest of this race to see how it turns out. Just wants to see all the footage and stuff. But yeah, feel free to leave a like and subscribe, and you guys know what to do. It's all YouTube stuff. You guys have worked it out before. And people have been putting up graphs saying like 40% of the people that are subscribed are clicking on the videos and stuff like that. I'm not going to worry about that too much. It's all analytical, and you guys don't need to know that unless you guys want to. Anyways, You guys know what to do with YouTube. I hope you guys do enjoy. And yes, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.
Good job, guys. That was good. That was good. Whew.